Hi everyone, this is Sonali. Thank you all for carving out some time for attending today's webinar on re-scripting your success in a new paradigm. To all the attendees out there, please type in any questions you might have in the Q&A section and we'll try to answer as many as possible at the end of the session. I would now like to introduce our speaker. With a sales and marketing experience of over 20 years in various sectors like hospitality, travel, insurance, financial management, and mutual funds, his last corporate stint was in the capacity of a national sales head of a mutual fund company. He has helped mold several businesses and groomed them to become profitable enterprises. With coaching as his passion and public speaking as his forte, business coaching comes to him as a natural instinct. He strives to mentor and coach those entrepreneurs to success who understand that things have changed forever and are more than willing to adapt to the new norms. With that being said, I would now like to welcome Mr. Alok Rampal.
Hi, good evening, everybody. So, time to rock and roll. And I welcome you all to this exclusive discussion. And we are going to be together for the next 1 hour. So we better be conversant with each other. It shouldn't be a one-way traffic. So two things I want to share with you before we sort of start discussing the business aspect is first, your permission. You can jot down your answer in your chat box. Am I permitted to use Hindi and English both? Fabulous, I can see a yes. Great, fabulous. Nice to know. Second is, before we start, two things, you know, that come to my mind immediately is, you know, if I don't talk about it now, I'll for the next 1 hour feel very, very heavy about it. Just I think 5 or 10 seconds of Shraddhanjali to our honored jawans who were martyred on the China border day before yesterday, and it has left a huge scar I think on everybody's psyche. And you know, pretending to be happy and our businesses not affected, our psyche not affected, is just not done. I mean, there are families bereaved and we've lost them on the line of duty. So just a couple seconds of Shraddhanjali to them before we start discussing business. So I will begin and then I will initiate and stop it. So let's pay homage to the departed souls. Okay, so thanks a lot for everybody who's cooperated, and this was important for me to start the day. So now is my screen sharing. Clear, Sonali?
Yes, it's clear.
Fabulous. So do we start? So that's the topic of discussion. Re-scripting your success in the new paradigm, dear friends. And this is the agenda, the overview. So are we looking at this particular lockdown and the unlock as a part of an adversity, or is it a hidden opportunity? The change in era, jo pehle hum sochte the BC and AD, wo phir aa gayi hai. हमारे ही सामने बीसी थी, हमारे ही सामने एडी है. अ डिस्कशन ऑन ह्यूमन माइंडसेट्स, अ डिस्कशन ऑन 3 Ds. आई लव दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. एंड द इमीडिएट एक्शनेबल्स फॉर योर वेंचर, द नीश एंड द यूएसपी एंड द ग्रेट इंडियन लैंडस्केप. सो आफ्टर वी फिनिश दिस प्रेजेंटेशन, दो चीजें मैं चाहूंगा कि हम लोग जब आप प्रेजेंटेशन खत्म कर दो तो आपके दिमाग में दो चीजें आनी चाहिए. पहली चीज, यार मेरे बिजनेस का यूएसपी क्या है. That should be the first thing that should come into your mind when you finish this presentation. And second is, how am I diversifying my business? So agar ye do cheeze aapke zehen mein aati hain, I will consider myself successful in interacting with you for the next 1 hour. Done? So here we go. First, this is a done to death quotation, but I love it always. Mind is like a parachute. It works only when it is open. So while I understand that everybody is too stressed in this unlock phase, ke yaar dhanda revive kaise karein, how is the business going to come back? So we are stressed. And many a times when opportunities pass by, just because we've not been able to open up enough, we tend to forget it. We tend to ignore them. So over the next 25 minutes, my request to you all is open your minds. You might be knowing most of the things that I'll be discussing. Because, you know, after all, I'm a part of you and we are all a part of team. So there'll be some points which will be new. There'll be most of the points you would have gone through in your life. Nevertheless, keep an open mind so that whatever is unique comes to your mind. Right? Is that a promise? Great. So, I know wala funda nikal dena agle 45 minute. Okay, so jab bhi aapko lagta hai ke are yaar ye to point mujhe pata tha or this is a new point, just say fabulous. I mean, I don't need to hear this, but you need just say fabulous. You can just put your thumbs up like this. If you find, aha, this is a good point that has been discussed, it is worth an appraise. So just in your chat box, do a thumbs up. Chalega, my day is made that way. Right? So for the next 45 minutes, there should be a lot of thumbs ups. There should be a lot of questions. There should be a lot of answers. And we should interact as much as can be so that everybody comes out happy out of this 1 hour of discussion. Fine? Fabulous. So, you know, this gentleman is a slide that I love very much. I am very fascinated by this country, Japan. Visited there twice or thrice during my career stint and have always found the people to be extremely knowledgeable and extremely adaptive. You know, this is one of the countries which has the highest propensity of earthquakes in the world. This is one place where there is an earthquake almost every second week. And chota mota nahi hai. The earthquake, the ferocity is well above 6 on the Richter. There are 4 islands called Honshu, Hokkaido, Kyunshu, and Shikoku. They exactly fall on the ring of fire. Jo maine aapko ring of fire dikhai hai, Japan lies on that. That is why it is always so prone to earthquakes. Now, the first thing that would have come to mind for these people was, this land is inhospitable. Any point of our going to stick around, why don't we migrate? No, but they never did that. They ensured, you know what happens? The reason for deaths and misery on earthquake is not because of the earthquake. It is because of the debris that falls after the earthquake. So the Japanese thought that why don't we create houses that don't give out debris when they fall just in case an earthquake happens. And thus came the earthquake-proof Japanese architecture. On to your right of the slide is a particular house that a Japanese has. Niche jo plinth ke niche jo zameen hai, the difference between the particular pole that goes in and the plinth base is very high, so that just in case an earthquake happens, the base also shakes with it and the entire structure doesn't come down. So you would have heard that Japanese, the fatality rate of earthquakes is very, very less. That is why it slips our news also most of the times. But if you go to their sites and find out there is an earthquake every other day, but they have learned to live with it. They know how to adapt and continue with life. And this, my dear ladies and gentlemen, is the time now for us to graduate. So, can I have the poll, please? Sonali? So, gentlemen, have your business parameters changed in this unlock phase? Arre baba, 100%. Key in your answers. Yeah. Ten seconds. Fabulous. Great. So 88% feel the business parameters have changed. I too agree. Everybody, without an exception, the business has changed. It's like starting afresh. So today, don't mind my saying, if you are a business owner, an SME, or a medium enterprise, or a small enterprise, or a startup, for all you know, we are all on the same platform. We are all on the same platform. For us, everything is a startup after this unlock phase. There are two companies I want to discuss about when we talk about adaptability. And these were household names when we were children, you know, when we were kids. Everybody used to know about a particular organization called Blockbuster. You know, they used to give videos on hire. Pehle kya hota tha ki picture nahi hoti thi, jo hum log hallon mein jaake dekhte the. Uske alawa, we did not have anything else where you could relook at the film. And Blockbuster was one organization that used to give videos on rent. And at the top, when in 2008, you know, there were 9,000 outlets of this particular store across the world. Australia, New Zealand, US, UK, and name not. Everything. It was a $6 billion enterprise. Ek banda Netflix ka, jiska naam Hastings tha, he approached. Why he approached? Because he was sick and tired of the late fees that he used to give Blockbuster for giving videos back late. Wo late fees lete har din ke hisab se. So now he thought of coming up with the idea that why don't we start video on demand? And he went and approached the Blockbuster managing director that this is my idea. I have already started working on it. I want to sell my company to you. You know what was the answer? Guess. Apna rasta naap. They did not see the change coming. What happened is Netflix came in as a roar. And it occupied the mindset. It occupied the thinking. It occupied the imagination, and Blockbuster started waning, and out of business it went. The last store closed in this year, 31st March. That was the last store that was closed in Australia. Imagine when change comes, and this was not abrupt, my dear friends, this was not abrupt. Our change that has come during the corona is abrupt. The second is the story of Kodak. हर एक घर के बच्चे की कहानी होती थी कोडैक की रीलों से हमने पिक्चरें खिंचानी हैं या कोई पिक्चर होती थी इट यूज्ड टू बी कोडैक रील्स इट वाज एवरी हाउसहोल्ड नेम फॉर एटलीस्ट वन सेंचुरी यू रिमेंबर आई एम श्योर यू वुड बी रिमेंबरिंग वेयर इज इट नाउ हिस्ट्री व्हाई दे डिड नॉट सी द डिजिटल एज कमिंग They did not see digital cameras capturing imaginations. They were approached by several digital companies to merge with them. They did not pay heed. They thought they are invincible. Their business model, impossible to win over. And what happened? Today, they are nowhere. Just a small change, but look at how rapidly it changed the world. Where are we, ladies and gentlemen? Are we open enough? Can we see changes coming in? And if we are seeing changes coming in, what are we doing to change, to adapt? Can I have the poll, please, Sonali? So friends, that's the poll. Do you think Blockbuster and Kodak would have survived had they been open and receptive to the changing environment? Go on. I think about 20 feedbacks are still left and counting. Yes. 15 to go. Answer is in unison almost. So 94%. Feel that yes, they would have survived had they understood that the change is coming in. The business models change, and when the business models change, they don't inform wo thali aur chamach leke nahi aate ki hum change ho rahe hain, hum change ho rahe hain, hum change ho rahe hain. Nahi, it happens whisper smooth. Now, as businessmen, are you open to accept this? So now, हम लोग पहले सोचते थे before Christ and AD. Time change हो गया. What is it now? It is before Corona and after disease. So हम लोगों ने 20 मार्च के पहले एक दुनिया देखी थी. हम लोग आज when we open up again in July, sometime when the entire things open up completely, we will find a new era after disease. Some of us have started resuming offices. Some of us are still at home. I am sitting out of my office. Most of the offices around me are closed. But when we all open up together, it will be sometime in July, August, however late that would be. That is AD era. Business ki offices wahi hain. Structures wahi bane hain. Lekin business change ho gaya hai. You know, we used to read in the Darwinian theory that, you know, survival of the fittest. Gone are the days. It's about survival of the quickest. Who is quick to adapt? Who knows what is coming? Who is quick to mold the business structure as per the environment? He's successful. You know, I love this quotation. I read it in a book somewhere. It is not the most intellectual of the species that survives. It is not the strongest that survives. But the species that survives is the one that is able best to adapt and adjust to the changing environment in which it finds itself. You may like it, you may not like it. We are finding ourselves in a new environment. You may like it, you may not like it, you'll have to accept the change. Change to ho gaya. What for us? So, there are four types of mindsets, you know. When you go and meet, now this is a new topic. I'm graduating you gradually to a new topic where the mindsets are the most crucial. What happens is, suppose you meet people every day. You find out, yaar, ye banda toh bada depressing sa hai, you know. Are you aware? You know, हमें कई बार लगता है ना कि अरे यार ये यार बंदा कितना यार थका हुआ है by God. इससे बात करने की इच्छा नहीं होती. और sometimes you find यार इस आदमी को तो रोज ही प्रॉब्लम है यार. And some people you find, the guy is extremely successful and he doesn't come down. So now there are four types of mindsets. One, specifically in this particular situation we are in, एक failure mindset होगा, हाय राम ये क्या हो गया यार, कोरोना कोरोना, and what has happened, why is this pandemic, I'm so depressed, every day you find so many people dying, what the hell is happening, the world is not worth living, it's so bloody depressing, that is failure mindset. The second is frustration mindset. Why doesn't the government do whatever it wants to? Why aren't there enough sanitizers? Why aren't there enough PPEs? Why aren't the doctors coming and checking us at home? I spoke to somebody. वो मेरे से कहता है, why don't the doctors come to our houses and check? भाई, we are a population of 1.4 billion people. Imagine. Conventional success mindset. You know, people who were before March used to say, boss, this is the way my business has worked. This is how it is going to work. I am not going to change because I was successful in the BC era. Now, is successful in BC era a guarantee that you will succeed in AD era? My question to you all. And one is the infinite mindset. Boss, things have changed. हो सकता है जिस बिजनेस को मैं कर रहा हूं वो भी चेंज हो गया है और मैं एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहा. An infinite mindset, you know, is what? It is like a sponge. It grasps everything. Who knows that you might want to change your entire business structure? Let it come. Let me assimilate my thoughts. Let me respond to it after I assimilated. Gather market intelligence and then act. That is called infinite mindset. Always open to change. Always open to change. Always open to look at options. Why is an infinite mindset so important? Is because it does not have any mindset. Mindset नहीं है. हमारा mindset होता है ना कई लोगों के, नहीं, this is how life is going to go. There's no mindset. It's independent. It's open to change. It can grasp and absorb everything. That is what an infinite mindset is. So now, what mindset do you think will come out as a winner? Sonali, can I have the poll? Keen, we have got 20 shot. Yes, guys, yes. Fabulous. Yes. 10 seconds to go. Great. Here I end my poll and look at the results. ₹85% believe that an infinite mindset is crucial in these times. Now, Devyo Sajjano, if that is crucial, is your mindset infinite? Are you open to change? Remember two things that I want you to take home with. Do cheeze. When you leave this, you should leave with two things in mind. Remember always, I'll keep asking you this. So now, there are three D's that have happened, you know, after March episode, there are three things that the organizations are forced to do. Ye nahi ki hum pehle nahi karna chahte the. Everybody knew that hum digital jana chahte hain. Everybody knew that virtual is the new normal. Par hum logon ne kiya? Nahi kiya. Everybody knew it is important to go reach the customers directly. Hum logon ne kiya? Nahi kiya. We were thinking procrastinating. यार ठीक है यार अगले साल कर लेंगे ऐसी कौन सी पड़ी हुई है. एवरीबडी न्यू दैट यू नो इफ यू आर वर्चुअली प्लेस्ड इट देयर माइट बी अ डे व्हेन यू माइट नीड टू वर्क फ्रॉम होम्स. एवरीबडी न्यू इट इट यूज्ड टू बी अ फैंटेसी लैंड. अरे घर से काम करेंगे यार. डिड वी डू इट इन रियलिटी? नो. दिस चेंज वॉज फोर्स्ड. यू मे बिलीव इट, यू मे नॉट लाइक इट, यू मे लाइक इट. दीज थ्री डीज have taken over your businesses. First is the drive to automate. If you are a startup, if you are an SMB, if you have not automated your businesses yet, hum kiski wait kar rahe hain? Okay, you know there are you may be an SME where you would have 40, 50 people working for your organization and you would have distributors for your product. Ke aapke plant se bankar saman distributors ke paas jaye and distributors then sell it to the retailers and then off it goes. Boss, times have changed. Do you have a direct to home strategy at place? Things have happened. Now, you may accept, you may not accept is a different question. The staff, if used to be 50 people staff, it is now reduced to 20. I was reading the papers yesterday. There's an organization called Kevin Care. You're aware? It's a South Indian based organization. They announced, that is what adaptability to changes. They announced that the entire head office is closing. Believe it. The entire head office of 450 people is closing. They have put notices on their head office that the entire thing is on rent. Everybody has mandated to work from home. Imagine the adaptability to the change. The business during this lockdown, the sales were up 30%. This is doing despite the sale, the increase in sale. This they are doing keeping the future in mind. अब हमारे खुद के स्ट्रक्चर्स वी हैव टू स्टार्ट क्वेश्चनिंग. नाउ माय क्वेश्चन टू यू जेंटलमैन एंड लेडीज इज सोनाली इफ यू कैन प्लीज. विच डी इज द सोर्स ऑफ इमीडिएट एक्शन इन योर बिजनेस? जो इन तीनों में से सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट था वो अपने बिजनेस में क्या लगा? Fabulous, you got 20 to go. Let's rush it up. That's a good answer. I am seeing the answer for all is going up. I tend to agree with you. So I'll close this poll. That's the result. I agree with you. You know that sare changes humne karne padenge humne. There's no option. So some may be immediate, some may be a month later. But this has to be, there has to be work from home rosters prepared. If you are a staff of 50 people, you'll have to ensure that 15 are in the office and rest are work from home. You know, going forward, I'll discuss the immediate actionables that need to be done. You might have to be a little, you'll have to bite the bullet somewhere. This I'll share with you separately. I can't toggle my slides. The damn thing is locked. So sorry, gentlemen. Okay, so sorry for this. I think whenever there is a poll, it sort of hangs. So immediate actionables for SMB and startups, I'll save on time now. If you are an SMB and a startup, you need a runaway plan for 18 to 24 months. That suppose you don't get finances. Suppose money is an issue. Will you be able to survive for the next 2 years? People talk about 1 year. No, I'm saying 2 years. Uncertainty is galore. You don't have control on the political situation. You don't have control on the pandemic situation. Things are happening and happening fast. The geopolitics are changing. As you're aware, the warmongering is happening. The prices are going down. The crudes are going up. And everything is happening is hanky-panky. Now, do you have a survival plan in place for 24 months? Don't expect any external funding if you're a startup for the next 6 months at least. 6 months, aapko umeed nahi karni. Because why will somebody want to invest money till such time that the things stabilize? Everybody needs reserve and cash for some time. So cut every bit of unnecessary expense that your organization might have. You may need to take some stern actions. Get closely knit with your core clients. This is the time that you sort of come closer as much as possible to your core customers, because they are the ones who will ensure that you survive and take off once things normalize. Now, another point is get your plan B ready. Plan B kya hota hai? Ke suppose we find that the next 6 months are crucial. We are not able to make it. I have seen many organizations, myself, shut down. I mean, this one organization that we've all grown up with, Atlas Cycle. It is history now. So sad. But, well, fine. Stop thinking about competition. If you're a same product range, why not, organizations come together? Let's look at the option of merging and relaunching operations. भाई हम कॉम्पीट तभी करेंगे ना जब हम जी पाएंगे ठीक से. When we are able to survive is when we will be able to compete. So you'll have to take a call. Have an action B, plan B in place. Why don't I have seen a concept in where was it? Mumbai, where four builders have come together and come up with something there, a project. कभी हम सोचते थे कि competing चीजें एक साथ हो रही हैं, नहीं अब हो रही हैं. Today, the situation demands keeping our egos aside and looking at merging like mindsets together. If you are a startup, freeze for some time. Okay? You may need to, if you are a staff of 50, you may need to take a call on some employees. You may like it, you may not like it, but that's how the stuff is. I mean, I am consulting somebody. Signed up with me. He was zero on business. What he did was, when March happened and when this pandemic happened, he was a 15 member staff. Sabko nikal diya. And it was a construction company. Fir laborers ko bhi jab wapas bhej diya. Now when the laborers are reluctant to come back, the 15, now he's alone. Don't do this. We'll have to find a midway. Don't start reconstructing businesses again. You might have to put it on neutral and keep it rolling as much as possible. So some bullets here and there, you'll have to chew. Okay. If you're a startup wanting to make it big in the space of Ola and Uber, where, in that space, I'm giving you an example, Flipkart and Amazon. Hum kehte hain ki hamara tech startup bhi Flipkart and Amazon jaisa ho. Bhai saab, they occupy 85% of the mind share. So till such time that you come up with a USP, don't launch a nationwide operation and burn cash. Survive as an SME. Find your boots and then expand going forward when time permits. The last point, very important. I was reading a book called Rich Dad Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. He happens to be one of my favorite authors. You know what he says, gentlemen? He says that for an entrepreneur, there has to be at least 6 active income producing streams. How many? 6. How many do we have? When I was in job, मैं वो मल्टीनेशनल में काम करता था. When I was in job, एक ही इनकम थी, नौकरी. I was short by 5. And imagine, I used to get up in the morning and say, कल नौकरी से निकाल दिया तो क्या होगा? Because I had no backup. The only money that I used to invest, since I was in mutual fund industry for quite some time, I used to invest in mutual fund. तो अगर उसको भी हम इनकम मान लें, चलो, तो 4 short. I was not, I didn't have a leeway of 2 or 3 months also. If you're a businessman, how many incomes, active incomes do you have? If you're surviving on one, is that the right strategy, dear friends? Or is this unlock phase a precursor to open up your mind like a parachute and look to diversify? You have to take a call. 4 or 5 streams of income are better, or 6. Imagine if Reliance didn't have Jio. Imagine if Dabur did not have Chyawanprash. You know, it is a 600% increase in sale of Chyawanprash the moment the pandemic happened. Imagine if Birla did not have the companies that they are diversified into. And what are you and me? We are all businessmen looking to be them. So why not look at diversification, additional incomes of streams of income? Why not today? Why not open mind enough? This particular slide, I'll just run you through. अगर हमारे पैंडेमिक टाइम में हमारे 3 कलर होते थे. वन वॉज रेड जोन, वन वॉज ऑरेंज जोन एंड वन वॉज ग्रीन जोन. कि भाई तेरा घर ग्रीन जोन में आ गया तो खुल जाएगा. यू नो, तेरा घर रेड जोन में है तो बंद है. तेरा घर यू नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन आर, यू नो, यू कैन बी इन ऑरेंज जोन. सो ऑन टू योर रेड जोन आर द इंडस्ट्रीज दैट हैव टेकन अ ह्यूज हिट. जॉब्स, you know, retail sector, travel, tourism, hospitality, auto sector, cinemas, logistics, local transport, live sports, in sab mein jo bhi businesses kar rahe the, they are in red zone. It is high time they graduate. If you have not done already, what are you waiting for, ladies and gentlemen? The winds of change are the social interaction, the work from home, that's a new trend that is coming, internet usage, health consciousness. Achanak log samajhne lage, meri immunity kaisi hai bhai? आज तक तो कभी पूछा नहीं था मेरी इम्यूनिटी कैसी है. यू नो, ड्रॉप इन पर्सनल एक्सपेंसेस. नाउ वी हैव लर्न्ड हाउ टू सर्वाइव. अप्रैल मई में वी जस्ट हैड 3 or 4 पेयर्स ऑफ क्लोथ्स दैट वी यूज्ड टू वेयर फॉर द एंटायर मंथ. एग्री इफ यू वांट टू, यू नो, रेज योर थम्स इफ दैट इज द केस. 3-4 कपड़े जोड़े और निकल जाते थे. द एक्सपेंसेस एट होम वर 1/4. फिर हम सोचते, साला हम करते क्या है? व्हाई इज दैट? Because we've learned how to survive. Okay, now on to your the green part is this, the runaway successes. You know, you have digital products. Achanak 500 rupees ke modules bikne lage hain online. How? Things have changed. Assignment based outsourcing is happening now. Ke tu mere liye ye kaam karte, tere ko itne paise milenge, tere ko naukri nahi milegi. Now, if you want to get into this is the green sector. Natural foods have gone up. Can you look at an additional business to diversify to national foods, natural foods, supply chains, online coaching? This is one of it. I'm sitting here. पहले 2 महीने पहले हम सोचते भी नहीं थे. This would be the case. Mental health. Now you find, you know, the moment you open Twitter, the moment you open Facebook, what happens is arogya, meditation classes, sustainability classes. How to endure during a calamity. ये पहले कभी सोचा था हमने? Never. Now you pay 1,000 bucks, they are asking. Mental health has become an issue. Suicides are happening. Now insurance has gone up, gone the roof. April sales were 80%. Can you imagine? April sales were 80%. Huge. So anybody who wants to diversify, these are the sunrise industries. Health, immunity products. You know, stuff like Dabur, Patanjali. Huge businesses. Now, this is the value proposition. Now, the most important slide, and I love this slide so much. What is the value proposition for your SMB or a startup? हम एक्स्ट्रा कस्टमर को क्या दे रहे हैं कि हम वही कर रहे हैं जो पहले करते थे. बॉस टाइम्स हैव चेंज ना. इफ यू योर बिजनेस इज नॉट ग्रेजुएटेड व्हेन विल इट नाउ इफ नॉट नाउ. आई गिव यू सम सर्टेन वैल्यू प्रोपोजिशन विच आर न्यूट्रल यू नो कॉमन टू ऑल बिजनेसेस. यू नो ऑनलाइन बुकिंग ऑर्डर योर प्रोडक्ट थ्रू ऑनलाइन. यू नो यू कैन टेल द कस्टमर्स दैट द डिलीवरी इज क्विकर. माई कॉस्ट इज कॉम्पिटेटिव. You know, now if you don't like my product, there is an easy money back policy. My products are eco-friendly. Now suddenly what has happened is it has become a, you know, status symbol. Eco-friendly maal use karta hun sahab. Now, why don't you make a campaign like that, which reflects the culture and sentiment of the particular samaj that we are in. Now, what does the culture recommend? Close to nature. What are the value additions that you can do to your organization? You know, when somebody purchases this product, it should reflect class. Can you build a value proposition like that? That, अरे बॉस मैंने ये नमक लिया तो टाटा का लिया. क्यों? Everybody has iodine. What is so special in this? Because he associated class with it. Does your product have it? Why don't we make a value proposition on these when we pack up and go, right? This is the particular slide I want to concentrate the most on. Because if you have a good value proposition, you'll come with a unique selling proposition, which is only unique to you. And if there is a USP that you are able to make, you require a coach, obviously, to come up with a USP and a campaign, but you are able to make a USP, what will happen is you will be differentiated from competition forever. They will not say ke wo jo namak hai wo Tata ka hai ke baakiyon ka hai, how is it compared? No. What was PSPO? Wo pankha wala? What was PSPO? It was nothing. That was peak speed performance of all, you know. God damn it, I came to know very late in life. But he captured the mindsets. So when you have a USP in place, there is no price, you know, there's no price competition. Ke yaar 4 rupaye mera product samne wale sasta de rahe hai, I'll have to put it down, give me discounts. No, if you have a USP in place, you know, you'll come out of the price competition forever. And once that happens, you'll be able to create your own brand. You know, you'll be able to directly relate to a particular class, and people will start purchasing because they associate their class with you. And that is when your USP becomes a winner and you have a winner's edge. So this slide is the most critical. If you don't have, can I have a slide? This poll is important. So there is, if this entire thing hangs up, please bear with me for a couple of minutes, but please Sonali, share the poll. Does your business have a USP? Be extremely critical. नहीं है तो कोई बात नहीं यार, अभी बना लेंगे. You require to sit with a coach. A coach is not only someone who teaches cricket or basketball, for God's sake. A coach can be for your business also. A neutral somebody who can analyze the business and suggest changes accordingly and guarantee your success. Now, I find a very interesting trend here. Some say, 53% say they have some USP, but 47% say they don't. So it's almost 50-50. That's fabulous. So if you have a USP, fabulous. Now, is it relevant even now? If it is not, let's rework on it. As expected, the damn thing is again hung up. Oh, now I get it. Okay, so I have tried to make circles out of it. So please, I apologize if they are not, you don't see circles in them. I see something ellipsoidal, but they are circles. So this is an important diagram. What does your brand, what your brand does well? You'll have to analyze yourself. What does your brand do well? What does your product do well? Is it in alignment with the customer's wants? And the third is, what your competition does well. Ask a time, if you don't take competition in account, it's useless. There are certain things where competition is better than you. That's all right. I mean, everybody is here in this business to succeed. So on the green zone is where the expectations of the customer and your brand matches. And that is your sweet spot. Don't waste time on the yellow ones. The green is the one that you need to find out. Sit with your coach and find out how to get to that green spot and make a USP. And the moment you start marketing a USP, you will not need to sell a product at all. So here, my last and the most important slide. What does the future hold for us Indians? Bharatiyon ke liye kya hai? Sabse pehla, 1.3 billion consumer base, captive audience, hamare desh ke liye. We don't need to export at all. The world is going to come to us now. As per me, 2021 onwards is our time. Bharat ka time hai. Does everybody agree? If everybody agrees, put a anguta, put a thumbs up. 2021 is onwards is our time. The next from 2021 to 2030 is our time, boss. We are going to take it over. You know, highest tech enabled smartphone users in the world. Abhi aur abhi hamari penetration bhi nahi hai. Imagine kariye. You know, people, the laborers have gone back and they are all smartphone enabled people. Do you think they're going to stop? Tier 2 and Tier 3 are going to be the biggest penetration going forward. Artificial intelligence and machine learning are going to take businesses in a jiffy like never before. Have you thought of enabling your business with AI/ML? Imagine a product that you want to display on the AI. What the customer will go through. You know, if you can, it reaches his laptop. This is my product, sir. These days are going to come. You don't do it, anybody else is going to do it. Third largest startup ecosystem in the world. As I said in the starting, hum sare startup hai. We are on the same page. So we are not different from a startup, stage two startup. Everybody's a startup now. Even I'm a startup. I'm teaching something new for the first time on a laptop. So the best place of the world to test new solutions is Bharatvarsh. I hope everybody is going to agree. The government is so supportive to new innovations. 35 crore gentlemen, the middle class. 35 crore captive audience who have the purchasing power. It's our time. India is expected to, now this just imagine, what will we be? Agar hum log wapas kabhi kisi din discuss karenge 2027 mein baith ke, what would it be? India is expected to grow from the current $2.7 trillion economy to $10 trillion by 2027. Matlab kitna? From 3 trillion to 10 trillion. That is the jump our nation is going to take within the next 7 years. Can you beat it? Aren't you super excited? Do you want to confine yourself to one business? If not, then what? What is in your mind? You know, it's time to unlock. It's time to unlock. India has created 80 crore new bank accounts, boss. And imagine these people. Aaj hum keh rahe hain gareeb tabke ke hain, bhai saab, they are all tech enabled. Kya hamesha gareeb tabke ke rahenge? Ji nahi. The biggest purchasing power is tier 2 and tier 3. Where are we, my friends? Penetration of e-commerce is just 10% currently. 90% हैं जो स्मार्टफोन लेके बैठे हैं, ई कॉमर्स चलाना सीख लेंगे आज नहीं तो कल। क्या आपका प्रोडक्ट ई कॉमर्स के ऊपर है? इज इट डिजिटली ऑन? नहीं है तो कब करेंगे? अगर आज रेवोल्यूशन नहीं है तो कब है? एंड सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट स्लाइड, लास्ट वन, हमारी कार्स, हम लोग कहते हैं कि ट्रैफिक जाम हो गया भाई साहब, यू नो देर आर ओनली 4% कार यूजर्स इन भारतवर्ष, 96% डोंट हैव कार्स। इन यूएस देर इज 1.3 कार पर सिटीजन, 1.3 कार पर सिटीजन। तो अब भाई किसी कंपनी को एक्सपेंड करना है गाड़ी बनाने वाली, नहीं कहां जाएगा वो, हमारे देश में आएगा ना? ऑब्वियसली दिस इज द बिगेस्ट मार्केट। नाउ इमेजिन वी आर ऑन अ वे टू बिकम अ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग हब, आर्ंट यू ड्रीमिंग बिग? इफ यू आर ड्रीमिंग बिग नाउ, देन व्हेन विल यू स्टार्ट ड्रीमिंग बिग? दिस इज आवर टाइम फ्रॉम 2021 ऑनवर्ड्स टू 2030, आवर लाइफ इज गोइंग टू चेंज। आर यू गेट इनफ फॉर इट? Now, the last slide, कि हम लोग करते क्या है? This is, you know, what is Action Coach all about? I'll just give you a brief. We guarantee your business success. We have one-on-one sessions where we sit with your business detail and script out a strategy for your business to succeed in every parameter. There are about 800 odd strategies that we have in the Action Coach portfolio, which can be specific to your business. And then we have got, now that will take time for you to understand, Action Club is a particular briefing session that our coaches have, where we have 4 power-packed sessions every fortnight. So meaning ke 60 dinon mein 4 session honge. Normally what I do, I cover topics like self-development, drive your sales growth. I've been a salesman throughout my life. Time management, this I was very weak in, by the way. So I've improved quite a bit. Find your niche, manage your cash. These are the 5 aspects that I brief our guests on. And if you are interested, I think this is the best time. Take sessions and then look at how does it impact your business, and then you can look at enrolling one-on-one and become a retained client and all that. But till such time, first, if these 5 modules suit you, I have a module running every fortnight. Every Saturday, the second Saturday that comes is my time with the clients. So how much do we charge? I charge 10,000 for registrations. You can register now if you want for $7,000, $6,000. You know, just to start, keep the ball rolling, because mind, my friends, now a coach is important more than any time else. Aage, it's not just about sports. It's about what future holds. Let's look at the cumulative 9 years. So, you know, this is what I had to share. If you have any questions, I'll ask Sonali to send the link in the payment, the chat box. If suppose anybody wants to register, Sonali, if you can kindly share the link.
I've just shared the link in the chat box.
I hope I was bang on time. Still 5 minutes to go. So this is a gentleman, what I had to share. I'm sorry, I did not write my email ID. My email ID, if you can jot down, just in case anybody wants to get in touch. alok.rampal@actioncoach.com. I am also available on LinkedIn, Facebook, my social media interaction platforms. So you can find me there. And if you have any questions, more than happy to take it.
Thank you so much, Mr. Alok. Thank you for such a wonderful session. And it was absolutely power-packed and energetic. And I'm sure all the attendees felt the same as well. So thank you once again. We have a few questions lined up with us. So if you don't mind, I'll just speak out the questions and please, you can answer them. Okay, so the first question we have is, which are the new growth sectors due to COVID where there is an opportunity for startups?
3. राइट डाउन जेंटलमैन, ये आगे आने वाले टाइम पर आप मुझे याद रखेंगे, AI ML, हेल्थ टेक एंड एग्री टेक. There is just, there are two or three MOUs that I have come across. Indian government has signed MOU with Brazil, Israel, and the third, I forget, on the health tech part. There's a lot of money that is coming in the health tech. Man, that's amazing. I'm associated with an accelerator, and on the panel of this accelerator on the health tech vertical are two doctors of Medanta. It's a total strength of about 8 doctors, out of which 2 are from Medanta. Massive changes. Government ko startups hi to madad karenge, aur kaun madad karega? So health tech, AI ML, and agri tech.
Perfect. Absolutely. So the next question we have is from Lakshmi. She says, how long do you think it will take for the travel industry to pick up?
Believe me, I'm a travel freak, and it's not just a Hawaii jazz travel. I love to travel by road. So I asked police wale se pucha, bhai jaane dega? To bhai bolta hai, main to jaane dunga. Aage jaake atka denge dusre state mein, to mujhe pata nahi. So it is as uncertain. I feel international travel will take time. I was speaking to somebody in Canada today, and Canada is completely closed till 31st of July. So it's going to take time. So international travel to do ek mahine apan bhul jaye, Diwali ke pehle ki taiyari kare aur uske pehle list bana le kahan kahan jana hai.
Perfect. So next question we have from Mr. Shanu Matthew. He says, what is the future of real estate in India according to you?
Good question, brother. It's going to pick up because it's very structured. Right now, if you look at the real estate cost, land or finished, it's low. But I feel it has a very, very good future. But the coming 2 years are tumultuous. So I think I agree with you, because I know that since you're coming with that backup, you would find uncertainty. Yes, for the next 1 year, it's critical. But yes, I mean, population is very high. It can't go on like this. Can't.
So the next question we have is from Mr. Shashi Shekhar Kumar. He's asking how to look for a job in this time.
Shashi, I was working in a multinational. I resigned and I left it in October, November. And my dear friend, if your age group is somewhere below 40, aray, why do you need a job, yaar? Why don't you become a boss of your own? I mean, you know, the next sunrise industry other than the startups is franchising. I mean, yeah, in minimal investments, you've got so many business opportunities. And if you are full of dreams and you've got hard work to back it up, yeah, boss, the organization is going to lap it up, yeah. Manufacturing is on an upswing. Imagine if this India, China, there are 3,300 products that India has shortlisted that our Chinese make. They require a backup. Let's you and me make it there.
Wonderful.
Thank you so much.
So I think we'll just take up the last question. Someone has asked if you can please share your journey in business. I think that's going to be a long one.
In business now, in business, how do I categorize in business? And I will go back. You know, I wanted to introduce myself starting me, but it didn't happen. I'll take you through my journey. I was a sportsman when I started my career. I was a cricketer and I played till the state level and was a bowler and was in the MRF Pace Foundation for 3 years. Had a very, very bad accident. And my knee was crippled. I had to give it up. I had to get operated. My cricket career flunked. I had to study afresh. I did on my crutches. I did my post-graduation. Oh, Baisakhi pe. I did my post-graduation and somehow managed to pass. So then I passed in 2 exams. One was Master's in Business Administration and one was Master's in Tourism Administration. Now, which option to take? I took up the latter option, Masters in Tourism Administration. Why? It's because my friend was doing it. I got into jobs after that, worked in hotels, was very bad tempered. I was asked to leave in one organization because of my bad temper. So I've had my share of misses also and successes also. So my career has been about 23 years. My business off and on I used to do. I gave up my job voluntarily because too much of traveling and it was all split up. I now have started taking up consultancy, and that is how I'm an action coach. So in business, yes, till about 6 months back, I was in job, but always a businessman.
Perfect. So thank you so much, Mr. Alok. Thank you once again for such a wonderful session. We still have a few questions left, but we are running short of time. So I'm really sorry we won't be able to take up all the questions.
No problem. I just hope that everybody would have had a good time interacting. And let's catch up even virtually after this thing finishes. And looking forward to be in touch with you virtually whenever need be. You can get in touch with me on the mail and we'll talk back. So with this, let's hang up and pledge to meet again. Until such time, Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you to all our attendees as well. We really hope we were able to add some value to your lives through this session. And thank you for being a part of this. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to reach out to me or to Mr. Alok. I'll make sure your questions reach out to him as well. So thank you once again. And yeah, we'll see you next time. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind. Bye-bye.